In my previous video, I showed you guys that I got handful of these CH551G microcontrollers from lcsc.com. At first glance, there's nothing special in these. These are 8-bit micros with small amount of RAM, but basic specs aside, there is something very interesting if we look a little bit further. The built-in USB and USB bootloader allow us to program these without any external programmers. And the price is another selling point. 30 cents when buying just a few, and it drops below 20 cents when buying 100 or more. Don't be afraid of these being SMD, this is one of the easiest SMD IC packages to work with. Even if you don't design proper PCB for these, you can use adapter boards that don't cost too much. In this first programming test, I have mounted one CH551G to an adapter board and that to the breadboard. Now I want to program or flash these. First thing to do is connecting 4 wires from the USB cable to the corresponding pins of the microcontroller, like so. One capacitor needs to be connected between 3.3 volts and ground. I am using 10 microfarad in this case. This is for the internal regulator's output. Without this capacitor, output would be stable and at least the USB wouldn't work. This should be enough. I should be able to program this over the USB. I will use the WCHISB tool downloaded from WCH's website. This has decent user interface and seems to be easy to use. If you look at the very bottom of the window, you can see that the application detects when I plug in the USB cable. It tells which device it has detected. To start programming, I need to select correct tab, which in CH551's case is the CH55 series. Then I need to select chip model. After doing that, device list shows all the connected devices matching that chip model. User file is the firmware that will be flashed to the microcontroller. For this demonstration, I am using one of the example files I found online. When it's selected, hitting download button will flash it to the microcontroller. I will not go into writing or compiling code for these microcontrollers in this video. This is a very new platform for me and I need to figure out what the best options are. Now that the firmware has been written to the microcontroller, the application detects when I disconnect the USB cable, but it won't detect when I reconnect it. That is because the microcontroller started running the newly programmed firmware instead of the bootloader. At first time, bootloader was activated because there wasn't anything else to run. There's a simple way of activating the bootloader, that is connecting 1 kilo ohm resistor between P36 and 3.3 volts. Usually you add a switch in line, but adding or removing the resistor works for this demonstration. When the resistor is connected, the microcontroller goes to the bootloader when the power is applied. Here's the schematic of the circuit used in this video. Pins 1 to 8 weren't connected to anything. Like I said, this CH550 series is a very new microcontroller for me. I don't know much about writing code for these, but I will try to learn and use these in the future. Chime in the comment section if you have ideas or something to add. Consider liking or subscribing. Thanks. Bye.